Mary McDaniel with MGM Law, and I'm going to talk a little bit about child support. Child support is governed by statute in the state of Florida. It is considered a vested right in the child. That means that parents that are divorcing are not in a position to contract around the amount of child support that's due. You can deviate from child support, but only in the event certain factors are present. For example, you can file a deviation of the statutory amount of child support if you have a disabled child or a child that requires additional expenses, or if for some reason you have a very wealthy child, which has never occurred in my practice, that doesn't need child support. That might be a reason to deviate. In general, child support is calculated according to a formula that was developed by the legislature. This formula takes the net income of both parties. Now, income can be wages earned, it can be business income, it can be disability payments that you receive, it can be regular and recurring gifts that you receive, as long as they are regular and recurring. So there are many things that make up income. But you start with the net income of both parties, which is after-tax income. Now, if you have a party that's not earning or that doesn't make any wages but is able to work, that is not disabled and that in theory could go out and get a job, many times will impute minimum wage to that person. So you first start with net income. You've got your two columns, and you can find online a child support guidelines worksheet, which is what it's called. And after you get the income, net income of both parties, you then determine what percentage of the time the children stay with each parent. And it gets a little tricky if you have, say, six children and each child is with each parent different amounts of time. But in general, let's say you have two children and they follow the same schedule. So in other words, the two children spend 1 week with the mom and 1 week with the dad. Well, that's 50-50 time sharing. So what happens first is if one party makes, for example, twice the amount of net income as the other party, then that the person making more money, their child support obligation is going to be higher by percentage than the other person. So if one person makes $1,000, the other person makes $500 net income per month, you've got $1,500 total. A person making $500 net income is responsible for 33% of the child support obligation. Now, what you do is you look in the guidelines, Florida publishes these, and you can look under, down one row is the combined net income of both parents, and then across the top are the number of children you have. So the amount due is in that graph, and you start with that number. And so one party is responsible for 33% of that number, whatever it is, and the party making twice as much as the other party is responsible for the remaining 66% of that number. Thereafter, you deduct things. For example, if one party is paying for the health care of the minor children, the health insurance payments and premiums, they get to deduct that from their child support obligation. If a party is paying for daycare and they pay it directly to the daycare provider, they will get to deduct that from their child support obligation. And at the very end, you're going to have one party who owes the other party a little bit more money, or substantially more money, and that's how child support is calculated. It is a little bit confusing because it's based on, of course, your relative percentage of net income to the other party's percentage of income. You also include the amount of percentage of time sharing you have. So how many days per year do you have that child? And you have to physically count those up, including holidays, how many overnights you have. And days don't count, only overnights count. And then you figure out your percentage based on 365 days in the year. And then you deduct your health insurance or your medical insurance premiums paid for the children, as well as the cost of your daycare. And you have to be ready to document all those things. If you were to go to court to argue over a child support amount, you've got to be able to document how much you actually do pay out of pocket for health care and daycare.